लेटेस्ट स्टडीज और लेटेस्ट स्टडीज
आई एम जेडी डॉक्टर सानवाल असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्या पीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर.
सो द कंपोनेंट ऑफ फ्लुइड्स
टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कांसेप्ट ऑफ
कोलिमेटर
रिसर्च मेथडोलॉजी. टुडे टॉपिक इज रिसर्च प्रोसेस कंसिस्ट ऑफ सीरीज ऑफ एक्शन or step necessary to effectively carry out research and desired sequence of these steps. The chart, we can also explain the research process with the help of flow charts. In flow chart, we define first of all, define the all the step of research process. First step is define research problem. Research problem. That is your topic is a topic of research is the research problem. Second step is review of literature. First you can review the concept of theory and various research findings. Next step of research process is formulate hypothesis. And next is design the research, including the sample and population. Next step is collect the data and exclusion. Analysis and test the hypothesis and interpret the reports. The chart indicates that the research process consists of a number of closely related activities as shown through 1 to 7th or 8th steps. But such activities overlap continuously rather than following a strictly prescribed sequence. At times, the first step determines the nature of the last step of two undertaken. If sequence procedure have not been taken into account in the early stage, serious difficulties may arises. We may even during the completion of the study one should remember that the various steps involved in a research process are not mutually exclusive, not they are separate or distinct. They do not necessarily flow each other in the specific order, and researcher has to be consistently anticipating at each step in the research process the requirement of the subsequent step. However, the following order concerning various steps provide a useful procedure guideline regarding the research process. Formulating the research problem, extensive literature survey, developing the hypothesis, preparation the hypothesis design, determine the sample design, collected the data, execution the project, and analysis the data, hypothesis testing, generalization and interaction, and preparation of the report, presentation of the report. Formulating the research problem, there are two types of research problem. Those which relate to state of nature and those which relate to relation between variables. At the outset, the researcher must be single out the problem he wants to study. He must decide the general area of interest or aspect of the subject matter that he wants to lie inquiry into. Initially, the problem may be started in a broad general way, and the ambitions, if any relating to the problem, be researched. then the feasibility of a particular solution has to be considered before a working formulation of the problem can be set up. The formulation of the general topic into a specific problem thus constitutes the first step of scientific inquiry. Essentially, two steps are involved in formulating the research problem, understanding the problem slowly and refilling the same into meaningful terms of analytical review. The researchers must seem to examine the all available literature to get the hints and inquiry with the selected problem. He may review two types of literature, the conceptual literature concerning the concept and theory, and empirical literature consisting of the study made earlier, which are similar to the one proposed. The basic outcomes of the review will be the knowledge as to what data and other materials are available for operational purposes, which will enable the researcher to specify his own research problem in a meaningful context. After this, researcher defines the problem into analytical operational terms to put the problem in a specific term as possible. The task of formulating and defining the research problem is a step for greatest importance in entire research process. The problem to be investigated must be defined, help discriminating the relevant data from the irrelevant ones. Care must, however, be taken to verify effectively and validity of the background facts concerning the problem. Professor W.A. correctly started the statement, the objective on the basis of the determination of data which are to be collected, the characteristics of the data which are relevant, relations which are to explore, the choice of technique to be used in the exploring of the final reports.
Discuss about the fluoroscopy imaging working.
Once the problem formulated, the brief summary it is should be written down. It is compulsory for the research worker.
We are going to discuss
writing a thesis for PhD or dissertation,
other parts of
to write a synopsis for the topic or submit to necessary committee of research for to approval. At this juncture, the researcher should undertake the extensive literature survey concerned with the problem. For these purposes, the abstracting and indexing journal and published unpublished bibliographies are first place to go. Academic journal, conference proceedings, government reports, book etc. must be tracked depending on the nature of the problem. In this process, it should be remembered that one source will lead to another. The earlier, if any, which is similar to the study in hand should be carefully studied. It would library will be great help to researcher at this stage.
And closed circuit TV system. When X-ray passed,
after the extensive literature survey, researcher should be stated in clear terms the working hypothesis. Working hypothesis is tentative assumptions made in order to draw out the test logical and empirical consensus. As such a manner, each researcher hypothesis is developed in the particularly important. Since they provide a local point for research, They also affect the manner in which the test must be conducted in analysis of data and in the equality of data which is required for the analysis. In most type of research, the development of working hypotheses play an important role. Hypotheses should be very specific and limited to the price of research in hand because it has to be tested. The role of hypotheses is to guide the researcher by determining the area of research and to keep him on the right track. It depends his thinking and focuses attention on more important problems. It also indicates the types of data required and types of method data analysis to be used. How does one go about the developing working hypothesis? The research problem having been formulated in clear cut terms, the research will be required to prepare research design. He will have to state the conceptual structure within the researcher will be conducted. The preparation of such a design facilitated the research to be efficient possible. Maximum information. The function of research design is to be provide the collection of relevant evidence with maximum expenditure or effort, time and money. Preparation of research design is appropriate for particular research problem and involve usually consideration of the following. The means obtained of information, the availability of skills and research, his staff, explanation of any way in which selected means of obtaining information will be optimized, the times available for research, the cost of cost factors relating to the research, the finance available for the purposes. All the items under the consideration in which field of inquiry consideration A inverse and population, a complete enumeration of the all items in the population is known as census inquiry. It can be pursued that it in such an inquiry when all the items are covered into element of chance is left and highest accuracy is obtained. But in practice, this may not be true. Even the highest element be biased and such an inquiry will be get larger and larger as number of observation increases. The researcher must be decide the way selecting a sample or what popularly known as the sample design. A sample design is a defined plan determined before any data are actually collected for obtaining a sample from a given population. Thus, the plan to be select 12 of a certain way constitute a sample design. A brief mention the importance of sample design, deliberating a sampling, conservation a sampling, sample, random sampling, systematic sampling, stratified sampling, quota sampling, cluster sampling, multi-stage sampling, sequential sampling, etc. Execution of the project is very important step of the research process. If the execution of project proceeds on the correct line, the data to be collected would be adequate and dependent. The researcher should see that the project is executed in the systematic manner and in time. If the survey is to be conducted by means of structured questions, data can be readily machine processed. In such situation, question as well as the possible answer may be conducted. If the data are to be collected through the interviewer, arrangements should be made for proper selection training of the interviewer. The trainer may be given in the instructions manual which explain clearly job for reviewer at each stage. After the data has been collected, the researcher turn to task analysis them, and analysis of data required to be number closely related to operations such establishment of categories. The application of these categories to raw through the coding, tabulations and drawing the statistical inference. Analysis work after tabulation is generally based on computation in various percentage and coefficient by the applying the various well-defined statistical formula. After the analyzing the data, as a started over, the researcher is positioned to test the hypothesis, if any he had formulated. Do the facts support the hypothesis and they happen to be contrary? This is the usual questions which should be answered and testing the hypothesis with this test, such as chi-square test, t-test, f-test, having the developed by the statistician. For the purposes, the hypothesis may be tested through the use of one or more such tests, developing upon the natures and object of such inquiry. Hypothesis testing will result in either accepting or rejecting, depend upon the finding of researcher results. If researcher had to know hypothesis to start with generalization, establishment of the basis of data may be started at hypothesis to be tested subsequent research time to time. After the hypothesis, we conclude the reports.
Mammography is a radiographic model.